Good morning, Body of Christ. According to William Carey, expect great things from God. Attempt great things for God. Church, He is expecting us to give our all in serving Him.
Call to worship. Hear the voice of the Beloved who comes leaping upon the mountains, bounding over the hills. Our Beloved, like a gazelle or a young deer, stands behind our wall, gazing in at the windows. Beloved speaks and calls to us. Arise, my love, my dear one, and come. For now the winter is past, the rain is over and gone. The flowers appear on the earth, the time of singing has come, and the voice of the turtle dove is heard in our land. The fig tree puts forth its figs, and the vines are in blossom. They give forth fragrance. Arise, O love, O dear one, and join me.
My faith looks up to Thee, Thou Lamb of Calvary, Savior divine. Now hear me while I pray, take all my guilt away. I tread, and grapes around me spread. Be Thou my guide. Bid darkness turn to day. Wipe sorrow's tears away. Nor let me ever stray from Thee. When as life's passing dream, when death's cold threatening stream shall o'er me roll, blessed Savior, then in love, fear and distrust remove. Oh, lift me safe above the ransomed soul. Amen.
Let us pray. Creator God, You have loved us passionately. We come today seeking Your presence and to know we are Your beloved. Enter our sanctuary and enter our hearts, that we may look into Your loving gaze and see ourselves reflected there, as You see us. Let our love for You reflect and mirror Your perfect love as we gather as Your beloved community. Amen. For the call to confession, Dear God, You call us to be doers of the Word, not hearers only. You call us to love the world with Your passion, and to let that love be expressed in justice, forgiveness, peace. Forgive us when our hearts are constricted with fear, and do not let your transforming grace open us to the world you cherish. Forgive us when we honor you only with our lips and not with our actions.
Holy One, in Christ you have shown us the way into your beloved community of mercy, love, and peace, in which you are making all things new. We come to affirm our covenant and sacred promise to be in a loving relationship with you. Thank you for giving us life. Open us, body, mind, and spirit, to your truth. Fill us with your grace so we can fall in love with your world and offer and experience forgiveness, reconciliation, and hope. Amen. Soul of God, let us pray. Lord, we cry out for help. We are sad, we are scared, we are angry, we are anxious, we are weary, we are overwhelmed. There is so much loss happening in the world right now. Be our refuge, God of comfort. Sustain the medical caregivers as they witness and bear the consequences of the action and inaction of humanity in this ongoing pandemic. Calm the storms, still the shaking ground, extinguish the raging fires, call back the flood waters, slake the dry, cracked, and groaning earth. O great peacemaker, draw closer. Let your children in Afghanistan be protected and rescued. Guard the Afghan people from what cruelty and terror few can imagine. Hold the people of Myanmar close as their nation continues to be inundated with political chaos, murder, flooding, and sickness. Lord, even when it does not make sense to us, you call us to pray for those who persecute. We place the Taliban and the Myanmar military, each of them also a child of God, in your hands. Turn their hearts, quell their hostility, and cease their violence. Lord, we pray for Church Among the Palms. As we celebrate Mission Sunday and the Fellowship of the Least Coin as part of our being one in the body of Christ. As we commit ourselves to Jesus' ministry of compassion in this place for this time. May your church thrive in its proclamation of good news and its preservation of the truth, its promotion of the right, and its nurturing of community. That all who behold your church would see in its life the first fruits of the life yet to come. The goodness and the beauty of your reign began among us even now. Praying for our online activities, worship, meetings, and the whole body of Christ gathered. Lord, we pray for strength and healing for Reverend Emil Puerto, Pastor Nida Baracol, Attorney Patricio Palier, Sam Martin, Manny Bravo, Felicitas Espanto, Dazzeline Hamias, Mrs. Rubia, Miss Luz Pagkaliwagan, Mimosa Ocampo, Mel Molina, Tita Mimi Ocampo's nephew who needs continuous strength, Ike Palier's health, for the brother of Alma Moderno Vicente, Jong, Hazel, and Liday Moderno, Bogs Lapis, Ken Oriarte and family, Florian Lerma, Mary Rasco who are all infected by the virus, praying for Reverend Ino Samonte, Reverend Dennis Noel Lunsod, for the family of Lee Baracol, Lola Doray Bautista, and Ambrosia O'Shaughness Health. May they experience your abiding and healing presence, O Lord, praying to all our brethren in Baer, Riverside, and Tadlac. The Church also extend our prayers to the bereaved family of Ike Palier, whose wife, Bing, rests in God's arm due to COVID. May you show us your mercy through the laying of your healing hands to each one of us. Lord, we pray for Christian School International. Indeed, many are expecting more to our ministry, but with you, O Lord, in the midst of all these expectations, we know that we can surpass them all and exceed their expectations. Thanking you, Lord, for all our old and new students and their respective families, our faculty, staff, and personnel, for entrusting to us those students and their families. Thank you, Lord. God, you are good all the time. Be with your ministry always. Lord, we pray for all pastors, deaconesses, lay leaders, pianists, choir directors, and other servants serving you through your church. Even we are on the last year of our term, continue to make us a blessing for the community we are leading. Thank you for all the provision you have given. Lord, we pray for all our co-workers and other clergies of the United Church of Christ in the Philippines. We pray for those in the leadership of the church who are now being harassed and imprisoned, like Bishop Manuel Tequis, Reverend Dan Balucio, Reverend Benji Gomez, and Reverend Nathaniel Valente. I, as a co-worker, condemn the state terror to our church people. Creator of all, embolden our grief and our rage into action. Help us enter the pain of others without centering our own. Help us engage in accountability and reparation, and to compel our leaders to do the same. Soothe our weary bodies, quiet our congested minds, cradle our aching hearts, and fill our mouth with your words of wisdom. All corners of the world need your presence, peace, and healing. Gracious God, renew our spirits. Remind us of your steadfast love that never ceases, that your mercies never come to an end, and they are new every morning. Great is your faithfulness, for we pray this day with the disciples of long ago, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever. Amen.
The reading of the Old Testament is from the book of 1 Chronicles 16:23-27. Sing to the Lord, all the earth. Tell of His salvation from day to day. Declare His glory among the nations, His marvelous works among all the peoples. For great is the Lord, and greatly to be praised. He is to be revered above all gods. For all the gods of the peoples are idols, but the Lord made the heavens. Honor and majesty are before Him. Strength and joy are in His place.
Our New Testament reading is taken from the book of Acts, chapter 1, verses 6 to 11. And it says, So when they had come together, they asked Him, Lord, is this the time when you will restore the kingdom to Israel? He replied, It is not for you to know the times or periods that the Father has set by His own authority. But you will receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you, and you will be my witnesses in Jerusalem, in all Judea and Samaria, and to the ends of the earth. When He had said this, as they were watching, He was lifted up, and a cloud took Him out of their sight. While He was going, and they were gazing up toward heaven, suddenly two men in white robes stood by them. They said, Men of Galilee, why do you stand looking up toward heaven? This Jesus, who has been taken up from you into heaven, will come in the same way as you saw him go into heaven. Brothers and sisters in Christ, the word of the Lord.
Blessed morning, dear CAP brothers and sisters. God's message for us this morning is entitled, The Missional Church, Persevering to be a Witness to the Nations. Before Christ ascended to heaven, He gave the Great Commission. The book of Acts is the story of how men and women took the Great Commission and began to spread the news of the risen Savior to many people and to many places. In Acts chapter 1, verse 7, Christ said to his disciples that instead of thinking about the date of his return, they should be thinking about the work spreading his message throughout the whole world. Christ is saying the same to us now. Instead of being concerned about Christ's return, especially with what is happening around us now, we need to be more concerned on how we can carry his message throughout the whole world. There are three things that we will learn about missions from these passages. One, we are witnesses of the power of God in missions. Second, we are witnesses of the work of the Holy Spirit in missions. And third, we are witnesses of the task remaining in missions. Number one, we are witnesses of the power of God in missions. But you will receive power. We are witnesses of the saving power of God. In Romans chapter 1 verse 16, it says, I am not ashamed of the gospel because it is the power of God for the salvation of everyone who believes, first for the Jew, then for the Gentiles. Not only that, we are witnesses of the destroying power of God. The power here in Acts chapter 1 verse 8, in its Greek form is dunamis, which means power to destroy. So this means we are witnesses of the destroying power of God. Power to destroy the works of the devil and power to destroy the desires of the flesh. I would like to cite an example about the story of the Bugalo tribe. The Bugalo tribe is located along the Sierra Madre Mountains of Nueva Vizcaya, Quirino, and Maria Aurora provinces. The Ilongots or the Bugalots are also known for being headhunters. Headhunting played a vital role in their culture. A young man cannot marry a girl without experiencing headhunting. He will not be accepted in the community if he cannot prove his manhood by killing someone and cutting his head off. Their anger, frustration, disappointments, and grief will only be appeased by headhunting. And to become popular, famous, or known, you need to do headhunting. No one is exempted. Men, women, children, pregnant women, dead people, lowlanders, and the Ilongots themselves fell prey to these headhunters. The Ilongots constantly live in fear. Their hearts are full of anger, hatred, and revenge. They trust no one, not even their closest friends or family. But all this has changed when God sent missionaries to teach them God's word and shared with them His love and forgiveness and salvation through Jesus Christ. God in His power has destroyed the work of the devil, which is headhunting. God in His power has destroyed the desires of the flesh in that the missionaries still went ahead preaching the gospel to these Bugalots, although they know they might be beheaded. God has the power to destroy the works of the devil and to destroy the desires of the flesh. The missional church perseveres to be a witness to the nations, not only because we are witnesses of the power of God in missions. Secondly, we are witnesses of the work of the Holy Spirit in missions. But you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes on you. The Holy Spirit's presence in us transforms our lives. The Holy Spirit's presence in us takes away our fears in doing missions. The Holy Spirit's presence in us gives us the courage to do missions. My wife and I have been missionaries with New Tribes Mission of the Philippines for 30 years now. And we were able to do this all because of the Holy Spirit's presence in us. The Holy Spirit's presence in us enabled us to reach the tribal people. The tribal people are animists. They worship the spirits, very different from us. The spirits are their God. They believe that spirits inhabit the trees and rocks, mountains and rivers. These spirits are their dead ancestors, ghosts, demons, and Satan. They believe good and bad fortune depends on the relationship with these spirits. Those who worship the spirits are powerful figures because the spirits reveal spiritual secrets to them. The sacrifice of chicken, goats, or other rituals can influence the spirits. Most of the tribal people live in faraway places, like in the mountains. Some of them live near the ocean. So they live in faraway places, and most of them are difficult to reach. God's Spirit in us enables us to reach others for Christ. We are witnesses of the power of God in missions. We are witnesses of the work of the Holy Spirit in missions. And thirdly, we are witnesses of the task remaining in missions. But you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes on you, and you will be my witnesses in Jerusalem, Judea, Samaria, and to the ends of the earth. Christ is saying that the disciples will be witnesses of His saving grace to the Jews who are in Jerusalem, to the Samaritans who worship the God of Israel and other gods, and to the ends of the earth, the Gentiles who worshiped idols and had no knowledge of the true God. Christ is saying that the disciples should be witnesses both to the Jews and Gentiles, both near and far. The disciples had done their job. They went to Jerusalem, all Judea and Samaria, and to some parts of the ends of the earth. But it's not enough. Our generation, our time, needs witnesses so that we can go to the ends of the earth. We are witnesses of the task remaining in missions because the harvest is still plentiful. I would like to mention the statistics from Joshua Project or Operation World and Operation World and the status of global Christianity. The total world population this time is 7.9 million, and the people groups of this 7.9 billion is 17,400 people groups. A people group is an ethno-linguistic group with a common self-identity that is shared by various members. The most dominant identifier of a people group is their language, but each unique people group also shares a common sense of identity, history, and customs. The total world population of 7.9 billion with 17,400 people groups has 7,400 unreached people groups. A people group is unreached if it has less than 2% Christ followers and less than 5% professing Christians, each with distinct language, culture, values, beliefs, and behaviors. About 42.5% of the whole population are unreached people groups. There are still more than 3 billion people in the world who are yet to be reached by the gospel, including 140 million in animistic people groups, unreached or unengaged, 865 million in Islamic people groups, unreached or unengaged, 550 million in Hindu people groups, unreached or unengaged, 425 million in Buddhist or Taoist people groups, unreached or unengaged. It is estimated that 7.8 billion people in the world speak 7,359 different languages. Only 9.5% of these has a complete translation of the Bible. John Wycliffe has said, "Let us make it known that it is every man's right to examine the scriptures for himself, to read them in his own tongue, that he may learn how to serve God." We are witnesses of the task remaining in missions, not only because the harvest is still plentiful, but also the workers are still few. 90% of all cross-cultural missionaries labor among nominally Christian people groups. Below 10% are in the unreached people groups. Christianity, all kinds, is growing at 1.18% per year. The center of gravity in the Christian world has shifted greatly southward to Africa, Asia, and Latin America. As of 2000, only 39% of the world's Christians lived in the West. By 2025, fully 70% of Christians will live in Africa, Asia, Latin America, and Oceania. Most of missionaries are from Africa and Asia. As a missional church, we need to persevere as Christ's witnesses to the nations, because we are witnesses of the power of God in missions. We are witnesses of the work of the Holy Spirit in missions. And we are witnesses of the task remaining in missions. So as Christ's witnesses, what can we do? Two things, easy to remember. First, we can go to the nations as missionaries. If you believe in your heart that God is calling you to become full-time workers, missionaries, then go. But if you cannot go, we can send missionaries or we can send someone to go. How do we do that? We pray to the Lord of the harvest that He will send forth laborers in the harvest field. Be an encouragement to those who have decided to go. Don't make life difficult for them if they want to go. And provide for the needs of those who can go. Christ wanted His disciples to carry His message to the nations, to the rest of the world. Christ is calling us to be witnesses to the ends of the earth. Let's do it. Thank you so much. God bless you. For the glory of God.
The Fellowship of the Least Coin is a worldwide ecumenical movement of prayer for peace, justice, and reconciliation, founded by our respected late Dr. Shanti Solomon of India in 1956. In September 1956, she was part of the Pacific Mission Team of six women from different countries that traveled in Asian countries after World War II for reconciliation and peace. It was organized by Dr. Margaret Shannon of the National Office of Presbyterian Women in the USA. Shanti Solomon was refused a visa to Korea in the middle of the trip while the group was in the Philippines. Having been left behind in Manila and together with the other Filipino church women, she reflected on the experiences of their travel in the war-torn countries of Asia and the national and economic barriers that kept women apart. By the anointing of the Holy Spirit, Shanti Solomon was inspired by the heart-touching biblical story of the widow's mite in Luke chapter 21 verses 1 to 4. To plant the seed for Fellowship of the Least Coin, which grew and spread in different continents of the earth. Presently, it is being run by Christian women in around 100 countries to support women's project to uplift them socially, financially, and spiritually, and to restore their honor and dignity. Church Among the Palms, let us now offer our Fellowship of the Least Coin's contributions to support women's work for justice, peace, and reconciliation all over the world. These list coins are symbols of forgiveness, love, and concern for each other. Let us offer to God our coins prayerfully. Please bring all the collected coins for the list coins to our church office so that we can turn them over to our conference. Let us pray. O loving Creator, we present ourselves in your divine presence to thank you for all the bountiful gifts of life. We are especially grateful for the fellowship of the list coin, which binds us together in love and forgiveness around the globe. Free us from all doubts and prejudices, we pray. Inspire us to live in solidarity with humankind, that we may know the joy of giving and receiving. Dear God, accept the list coin, token of love. Make us mindful of the miracles of these coins. Let us honor your creation with love, as shown through the life and resurrection of your Son, Jesus Christ. Amen.
For the call to offering of lives and labor, every generous act of giving with every perfect gift is from above, James 1:17. Thank you for the generosity within us that comes from you. Fill us with the hope of young love. May we give generously to your church.
Mapagpalang araw po sa inyo, kapatiran ng UCCP Church Among the Palms.
Ako po ay nagpapabot ng pasasalamat sa ating mga kapatid na naging daluyan ng pagpapala na ipinagkaloob sa amin noong December at May.
Po ay malaking tulong po sa aking pag-aaral at sa aking pong pamilya.
Sa panahon ng pandemyang ito, ay patuloy nating sinisikap na tayo po ay magsama-sama ng isang iglesia at maging matatag sa ating pong pananampalataya upang sa ganon ay ang pandemyang ito ay hindi makagupo sa ating pananampalataya at paglilingkod sa ating pong.
Naalala ko tuloy yung story ni Jesus and the believers after healing, after begging for healing from Jesus. When Jesus gave it to them and awarded it to them, ay isa lang ang bumalik para magpasalamat.
Tinitingnan ko po na ang inyong salapi na ibinahagi bilang pagpaparamdam ng inyong pagkalinga sa maliliit na iglesia, gayon sa aming manggagawa ng simbahan na sa panahon ngayon ng pandemya ay nahihirapan sa kalagayang pampinansyal.
Talakip ng akin doon sa bayan ay magalak at malungkot po.
Maraming salamat po.
Nawa ay patuloy kayong pagpalain ng Diyos sa iyong pagsagawa ng ministeryo ng ating Panginoon at sa pag-abot sa mga na inyong malasakit sa mga nangailangan. Purihin ang Diyos sa iyong patuloy na pagkilos at sa pagpapahayag ng Ebanghelyo ng Diyos sa mapanghamong panahon ng pandemya.
Maraming salamat po.
Maraming po salamat sa inyo lahat.
us pray, each of us is a fragile miracle, evidence of God's creative hands and amazing grace. Each of us is a unique, unrepeatable gift to the world. We are proof of God's love, and so we who are the gifts of creation now give gifts to our Creator, gifts brought in love. Amen.
Jesus, the very thought of Thee with sweetness fills my breast, but sweeter far Thy face to see, and in Thy presence best. No voice can sing, no heart can nor can the memory find a sweeter sound than Thy blessed name, O Savior of mankind. O hope of every contrite heart, O joy of all the meek, to those who fall, how kind Thou art, how good to those who seek. But what to those who find that is no tongue or pen can show, the love of Jesus, what it is, none but His loved ones know. Jesus, our only joy, be Thou, as Thou our prize wilt be. Jesus, be Thou our glory now, and through eternity.
Let us pray. O God, in the face of all these things, and the mission still is the same, that all humanity might wonder at Your love and purpose revealed in it, to Your great glory, spreading the good news of God's love to everyone. Lord, in Your holy presence, we lift up to You the silent prayers of our hearts. You are truly a mighty God of all. You have heard all our prayers with the guidance of the Holy Spirit. In Your perfect time, all this will be possible. As we come to a close, may we remind ourselves that we are the light and salt to all our family, friends, church, and community. And now, go back into the world assured of God's love for you and for us all. Go back into the world with joy and energy to create God's beloved community wherever you are. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen and amen.
Shine on.
A warm welcome. According to Mike Istachura, the mark of a great church is not its seating capacity, but its sending capacity. It's the last Sunday of August and the second Sunday in Kingdom Tide, where we are giving emphasis to mission and the fellowship of the Discoins. Indeed, God is good all the time. In spite of the situation we have now, let us continue to spread God's word. And through us, may others know that He is God. Glory to God. For our church and community activities, today at 1:30 p.m., we will have our church Sunday school, which used to be choir Sunday school only, but it is now open to adults who wants to join via Zoom. Here are the reflective questions based from today's sermon, which will be used later during our church Sunday school and can also be used for sharing with your respective family. At 10 a.m. today, we will have our children's Sunday school. At 1:30 p.m., we will have our church Sunday school. And at 7 p.m., we will have our Light and Salt Stories Rewind, one of our youth activity. And on August 31, Tuesday, we will have our Timothy Bible Study Group at 6 p.m. And September is Christian Education and Nurture Month. So in September 1, Wednesday, we will have our Midweek Prayer Meeting at 6 p.m. September 4, Saturday, we will have our NESCON Christian Mission Fellowship, a virtual activity at 9:30 a.m. We will have also our BCE and Timothy Discipleship Group at 5 p.m. September 5, Sunday, we will have our Communion and Christian Education Sunday celebration, and it is also our third Sunday in Kingdom Tide. Our preacher is yours truly, and our liturgist is Diaconal Minister Joyce Letana Rizal. And at 1:30 p.m., we will have our church Sunday school. And at 4 p.m., we will have our youth Bible study. So please be guided. Everyone is invited to join the online church activity schedule of the following groups: MISPA Bible Study Group, BCE and Timothy Discipleship Group, Couples Fellowship, Church Sunday School, Children's Sunday School, Youth Bible Study, Timothy Bible Study Group, Senior Citizens Fellowship, Midweek Prayer Meeting, Youth Supplemental Activity, Light and Salt Stories. All our Sunday worship services will be pre-recorded and premiered at 9 a.m. in our CAPS Facebook page and CAPS YouTube channel. For CAPS financial blessings for the month of July, for our tithes, we have 272,320 pesos. For loose offerings, we have 86,221 pesos and 50 centavos. For love offering, we have 140 pesos. For evangelism offering, we have 500 pesos. And other receipts, we have 26,400 pesos. For a total of 385,581.50. So let us thank the Lord for all His blessings. For any inquiries or information, please feel free to contact us, your administrative officer, administrative assistant, part-time music director, Christian education worker, administrative pastor on the numbers flash on your screens.